रजो जुषे जन्मनि सत्व वृत्तये स्थितौ प्रजानां प्रलये तमस्पृशे अजाये सर्ग स्थिति नाश हेतवे त्रयीमयाय त्रिगुणात्मने नमः। सो दिस इज द मंगल श्लोकम ऑफ कादंबरी। वी वोंट बी स्टडीइंग दैट पार्ट, वी आर गोइंग टू रीड ओनली शुकनास उपदेश। So let me go through a couple of, I am not sure how much you're exposed to Gadhyam, so let me give a quick history of what is Gadhyam. The Lakshanam for Gadhyam is Vritta Bandha Ujjitam Gadhyam. So this is the Lakshanam that is given in Sahitya Darpanam. You can find it in Kavya Darsha also. Vritta Bandha is meter, without any meter. Ujjitam is without any meter. So the Gadhyam is a type of literature which is not bound by metrical devices. So that sort of literature you will find right from Vedas. If you look at Yajurveda, the Samhita portion itself in Yajurveda will have a lot of Gadhya portions. The explanatory parts are also in Gadhya. And then when you come to the Purana literature also, there are Gadhyam portions. We always think that Puranam has only shlokas in it. But no, if you look at Bhagavatam, you will know how, from where Bana would have gotten this idea of writing long, long samasas. Even in Bhagavatam, you have a lot of prose portions. So prose is probably a very mild way of saying. So there are different types of Gadhyam here. The Purana type of Gadhyam is very different from the Vedas type of Gadhyam. The Gadhyam that you find in Veda probably would be followed by the Sutra Granthas, which is like the Dharma Sutra, or those also follow a type of prose literature. Mahabhashyam, of course, is more like a conversational setup, where the student asks a question and Patanjali replies, and that's how the setup of Mahabhashyam is. It is during the Mahabhashyam time, you had the Sutra Granthas also, which were also, let's say, the Bijam for the Gadhyam, Gadhya Kavyam. Then you had the Bhashya Granthas like Jaimini Sutras Bhashyam or Nyaya Sutras Bhashyam or even Shankara Bhashyam, Brahma Sutra Bhashyam, all that also form a type of Gadhyam literature. As always, the kavis always take this, any given literature, to a different level. When you had Padyam, you found the meters and chandas and everything in Vedas also, but the kavis took it to a totally different level in their Kavyam. The same way, Gadhya literature also found a different playground in the minds of the kavis. They were, they had a better, let's say they were, because it was not bound by meter, they had a bigger playground on hand for them to give full rein to their creativity, right? So when you come to the Kavya literature, the first example of a proper Gadhyam you see would be Subandhu's Vasavadatta. And that I won't say is the height of Gadhyam. It is only Kadambari or Harshacharitam that is the pinnacle for Gadhya literature. Because Vasavadatta is just abundant with the Slesha. There is nothing, no beauty or rasana. The rasam is not, does not have a prominent part in Vasavadatta. Dashakumara Charitam is a little bit better. It is like reading the stories of 10 princes are given in that, and it's more like a storybook. And it's a wonderful read. Dashakumara Charitam is a beautiful text to study. The divisions are much more clearer, and even though you feel that you're going into a loop of story after story and you don't know where everything is going to come and connect, still it's a beautiful journey, this Dashakumara Charitam. Then we have Banabhatta, who represents the pinnacle for Gadhya literature as such. So his Kadambari is like, you know, for want of a better word, I have to use the word magnum opus. You know, that's so oft repeated word I don't like to use. But still, Kadambari is a magnum opus in Gadya literature, whatever you want. You know, if you want Vedantam, it is there. If you want psychological advice, it is there. If you want beautiful description of nature, it is there. A character analysis is there. Every aspect of a kavyam would be present there. He has also included some shlokas in it too. So the beginning, because Gadyam does not have shlokas in it, it has one or two shlokas. In the beginning, he gives some 20 shlokas. So his Mangala shlokam itself runs for 20. So I just take up the first one, which is on Brahma Swarupam, Paramatma Swarupam. So I just took that up and I say the first shloka before the class. That's it. Another type of Gadya literature which is interspersed with a lot more of shlokas is the story of Hitopadesham, Panchatantra or Vedala Panchashati. These are also a type of, after the 7th century Banabhatta, you find a couple of Gadya Kavyams which have not been so popular, I should say, like Shivaraja Vijayam or Mandara Manjari, Vemabhupala Charitam. There have been a couple of Gadyas which are not as popular, and people would still want to keep these for any syllabus if you find in many universities. So Gadyam has two classifications. One is Katha, the other is Akhyayika. Katha is fictional and Akhyayika is more like historical, which will also have some portions of autobiography in it. And the only Bana has written both styles. Kadambari is a katha, whereas Harshacharitam is an akhyayika. So the Harshacharitam, he starts off with the first four, I think three uchvasas are about Bana's own story. It's like an autobiography. And then he moves on to Harshavardhana, Prabhakaravardhana, you know, their story goes through from fourth uchvasa. So the Akhyayika is more based on historical. It is not completely historical. It is also a historical fiction. So he would add his own stories in it to make it more rasapurvam, interesting for people. Katha, of course, again, you have two divisions inside the Katha. One is Utpadya Vastu, the other is Kalpita Vastu. Utpadya Vastu is totally fictional, where the story completely is the poet's own imagination, like Dashakumara Charitam. There is no bijam from anywhere. If you take Vasavadatta, Subandhu's Vasavadatta takes the story from Brihat Katha Manjari, which was original, and that is where he takes his Vasavadatta or Udayana. It is popular folk tales that you find that are present everywhere in the country. So he takes his Vastu, Vastu is the plot, from those folklores, and he makes it into his Gadya Kavyam, which is Vasavadatta. Whereas if you look at Dashakumara Charitam, completely, totally fictional. None of the 10 kings are resembling any of the kings. He probably has some figure in mind, but we don't know about them. It is a totally fictional work. The same with Kadambari. Kadambari is also completely a fictional work, where it is the Vastu is from the Kavit Pratibha. That is why you call this Gadyam as Kavinam Nikasham Vadanti. It is like a touchstone for poets. Not many poet will attempt to do this. For a Mahakavyam or a Kavyam, you have set rules. When you always have rules, it is easier to live life. Because you're bound by this, you know, okay, I have to do this, I have to do this, I have to do this. If you don't have a rule, if you have a bigger, to play around with a no rule thing is much more difficult, I find. You know, and to be interesting, to make it interesting for people. So that is why Gadyam is called a touchstone for poets. Like Kavinam Nikasham Vadanti. Now we looked at the two divisions of Gadyam, Katha and Akhyayika. There is another type within the Gadyam itself. There is another type of divisions or how it is made. Rachana Pranali is something, how it is, how the within the plot itself, the way the poet writes, the style of the poet. It is not about Vaidarbhi or Panchali or Gaudi or that sort of a thing. But when you look at the Gadhyam as such, the sentences that are there in the text itself, how is it formed? So the main point here is whether it has samasam or not, whether it has a little bit of vrittam or not. Vrittam is meter. There are four types of styles with which a poet writes. It is not that one poet follows only one style, but all four types of styles are present in the kavyam itself. So the poet may use muktakam for certain styles. He may use utkalika prayam for certain things, churnakam for certain things, vrittagandhi for certain things. It depends on how the mood of the poet goes. So for some meters in Mahakavyams, if you take Mandakrantam, for example, Mandakranta is a meter which is used more for Vipralamba Shungaram or Karunam or Shungara Rasa, Shanta Rasa. You can't use it for Viram. Mandakranta itself, the meter itself goes in that manner. So you will have to use it for slow moving, more sensitive topics. That is how, so in the same manner, here also you will find a similar treatment that the poet gives for whether it should be big samasas or small samasas or samasa rahitam in that manner. So the four styles are muktakam, vritta gandhi, utkalika prayam, and then churnakam. Muktakam is where there are no samasas. You'll find all four styles in Kadambari. Let's say Mahashweta is, I think, in that section where Mahashweta, Polambara, she cries when Kapinjala, Pundarika dies. And at that point, she's expressing her grief. She won't be talking in long samasas there. She won't be thinking about long samasas there. So she would just talk, she would just cry what comes to her mind, which would be just small words, you know, ha, Pundarika, ha, whatever. That's all it will be. So samasa rahitam. Muktakam is one style where there is no samasa. Vritta gandhi, there is no meter, but it seems as if there is a smell of vritta there. There is a smell of meter. As you read it, you might find that certain portions will fit upajati. Certain portions may fit Mandakranta. It may look like it, but it won't have four padas. As you read it, you will find, oh, there is 17 aksharas and it seems to fit the meter of this Malini or something like that. That is called Vritta Gandhi, but it is not Gadhyam. So Vritta Bhaga Yutam, yet it is not Padhyam. It doesn't have four sections to it. Utkalika Prayam is Dirgha Samasa Adhyam. So this Vritta Bhaga Yutam can be mostly where there are, descriptions of cities. And as he ends and he is looking at very similar types of descriptions, he would probably use this. Utkalika Prayam is Dirgha Samasa Adhyam. Mostly descriptions, you will have long samasas where one word starts from one part of the sentence and you will find it ending somewhere after some four sentences. The word would not have ended after four sentences. So he has a lot of descriptions like that.
Oh, that is interesting. That means a samasa pada crosses a sentence boundary.
What is a sentence boundary?
Phrase.
Okay. So it's a phrase which, I mean, in a book print, I'm saying, it will just run to four lines. That's what it is. Churnakam is Alpa Samasa Yuktam. It has very little samasas, maybe when there is a conversation or when someone is trying to say a story to another person, it can happen. Or even within a description, you can have long samasas in one section, then he may decide to say smaller parts. You will find all of these in Shukanasa Upadesha also, in the section that we are going to see. Utkalika Prayam, probably not so much, because he does deal with a lot of longer samasas in description parts. So that is something we may not see. So Banavata has not only written Gadhyam, he has also written Chandi Shatakam. He has written two natakams, which is Parvati Parinayam and Mukutataditakam. Parvati Parinaya, the first part of Parvati Parinayam itself says that it has been written by Bana. So we have proof for that. But Mukutataditakam and all, we don't have any proof for all that. We just take it because some commentator, through secondary source, we come to know that he has written this natakam. So I won't, he's more popularly known as the author of Harshacharitam and Kadambari. Kadambari has two parts. One is the Purva Bhaga. He died when he finished the Purva Bhaga. He didn't finish the text. The second part has been written by Bhushana Bhatta, his son. It was completed by him. So the first part ends with the Kadambari and Chandrapeda meeting each other. And it ends with that. They're falling in love with each other. And then later, in the Uttara Bhagam only, we find the entire story completing. There are parts other than just this Purva Bhaga and Uttara Bhaga. There are some sections within where people, you know, these sections are only made by commentators or publishers. According to Bana, he has not done any such divisions. It is just two sections. One is Purva Bhagam, and he may not have even done a section probably. It is because Bhushana Bhatta had to complete it. He probably named it as Purva Bhaga and then he completed the Uttara Bhaga. Possible. So otherwise there are no divisions. Not necessary that a Gadhyam should have divisions. Two very interesting quotes about Kadambari. Bano Chishtam Jagat Sarvam. Bana Uchishtam hi Jagate Sarvam. What Bana has covered everything in his two works, that whatever he has, Uchishtam is spitting out. Whatever he has, chewed and let out is what is this world, which means he has covered every aspect. If you think of right from morning sunrise to the night, every time of the day has been described in Kadambari. I'm not exaggerating here. Every part has been described. A city has been described. Marketplaces, forests, lakes, mountains, animals. You know, name it and it is there. You know, people, a king, even a an old man pujari in a Jarad Dravidaha. He is actually describing a South Indian. Old South Indian man in a temple. And so the way he has described people is also very beautiful. That's why they say Kadambari Rasajnanam Aharopi Narochate. Once you get the rasam of Kadambari, you won't feel like even eating it. Kadambari Rasajnanam Aharopi Narochate. The section we are going to see is Shukanasa Upadeshaha. There are a couple of sections within that Upadesha. Before we go into that, let me just give a small recap of where this comes exactly in Kadambari. This is maybe somewhere in the middle, you could say.
Is Kadambari all about in the first place? You know,
That is what I will give you the whole story now.
Okay.
And also, what is that? Katamukha and Maheshwara, something you had Maheshwara.
These are all, Mahashweta is a character there. Mahashweta Vrittantam is her story. Kathamukham is one section. I will come to that when I give you the story now. You will understand what these two are. He starts off, Kadambari is the name of the Naika. But the Naika will come much later. We won't even know about her at all. And 3/4 of the Purva Bhagam will be over. And then only Kadambari will come there. So he will start off with one king named Shudraka, who is ruling the kingdom, and there will be a description of that king. One woman from the forest, a forest dweller, she comes with a parrot. So this is how the story starts. She brings a parrot in a cage. The parrot says a shloka and welcomes the king. The parrot says this shloka. So the king is very amazed by how a parrot can speak. And then he says, I will have this parrot, because the woman who brings the parrot, she says, I cannot think of anybody else to gift this parrot to, because he's extremely gifted and he can talk, he knows shastras, he is very well versed in everything, and I can only gift it to the king. And she comes and gifts it to him, and the king asks him, how did you come across this voice? I know a lot of people, you know, the Shastra says, Veda says that elephants and Shuka, Maina in the bird, Sharika, these birds all had the ability to speak at one point, and then because they gave a false witness, they stood as false witness for Agni or something like that, and they lost their speech. There is a small story there also in Mahabharata. Mahabharata is just filled with such stories you can find. So this, there is nothing surprising about it, but I understand you are speaking very clearly, and not like you know, you have been under the curse of that Agni or something like that. So then this parrot starts his story. He says how he was born in the forest and his two very old parents, and those old parents tried to protect him. There was a hunting expedition. A lot of Shabara hunters came and tried to kill all the animals and wanted to take the birds also. They killed his father, and the father protected this small baby parrot under its wing. And he also acted as if he was dead, and the hunters walked away. He felt so thirsty, he went to the, he was found by a Tapasa Kumara, Haritha, and that Tapasa Kumara took him, brought him to life, and took him to Jabali Maharshi, his father. So Jabali Maharshi, everybody in that ashrama wanted to know from Jabali Maharshi, what is the story of this parrot, and why is he like this? Because Jabali Maharshi says, you know, asyaiva avinayasya phalam, he is you know, experiencing the bad karma that he has performed. So that's what he says, Jabali. So everybody gets curious about this and want to know. Now, till this is your Kathamukham. From now, we'll start the story as such, where Jabali Maharshi starts the story of the parrot. We don't know who the parrot is until Uttara Bhagam comes. Who this parrot is and what his role is and all that. Then he starts off the story of Tarapida, who is a king of Ujjaini, and he did not have any children. Then one day they dreamt that they did a lot of things, and Vilasavati cries, his wife cries a lot that she is not able to get a child, and then they get a dream that the sun, the moon enters Vilasavati, and she gives birth to a child. That child is known as Chandrapidaha. Right? The same way, the minister Shukanasa also has a child at the same time, and that child is called Vaishampayana. They both grow up together, just as Tarapida and Shukanasa. As they grow up, the father builds a Vidyagraham for this Chandrapida, and he asks Chandrapida to be, appoints a lot of teachers. It's a separate boarding house for him, where he has to stay there for 16 years, and all tutors will come home and teach him and go back. Whereas he and Vaishampayana spent their time 16 years studying. I wish we had some, but at the same time, he was also very close to his parents. They would come and visit once in a while. After his study period, he came back, and his father says, you have to go on a Digvijaya Yatra. Chandrapida goes on a Digvijaya Yatra, even though the entire earth had been, this is always there. In Raghuvamsha also, you will find this sort of a description. Even though the father had won over all the countries, he still has to go and establish his sovereignty. That is the way of showing their, Alumai. You have to establish that. After Chandrapida comes back from the Digvijaya Yatra, Tarapida, his father, desires...
Alumai meaning masculinity? Alumai? No, what do you
prabhutvam.
Mean?
Prabhutvam.
Oh, prabhutvam. Okay.
Aldradhingramulu.
Oh, alright. Conquering.
Conquering, yes.
Okay.
Alumai ingarche Ishwaratvam.
Ishwaratvam, okay.
Prabhutvam. So Chandrapeda goes after the Digvijaya Yatra. Tarapeda, his father, decides to crown him as the crown prince, Yuvarajya Abhishekam. He decides for that. Before doing that, he goes to Shukanasa and he tells him, so all the arrangements are being done and he has to go and meet the minister, and the minister, Vandiya Okkare Cholren, Abdini, he will start, you know, if someone comes and if you're in a position of advising, you're a minister, right? Shukanasa is the minister of that country. So he will naturally say, this is a nice opportunity for me to start giving him advice. And he starts his advice. This advice is one of the gems of Sanskrit literature. It's so beautiful that I don't know, I can just dwell on just two sentences for half an hour. It's such a brilliant piece of work. And most oft-read piece also of Kadambari. Whether people have read the entire Kadambari or not, they would have definitely read this part. If they say that I've read Kadambari, you should ask them if they know certain other parts also, because they would probably just say, I've read Shukana's Upadesha and I've read Kadambari. That's how popular this is, this section is. So it is the Upadesha given by the minister Shukanasa to Chandrapeda. After this entire episode is done, after he gives the advice, the Yuvaraja Abhisheka happens and he goes on a yatra again. And after the yatra, there he meets Mahashweta, who is a tapasi, who is in the forest. And he asks her, why you are here in this forest? She is a Gandharva Putri. And then that is the Mahashweta Vrittantam. She recites her story about how she fell in love with another Pundarika, another tapasa, and how he died. It goes on. Her friend is Kadambari. And that Kadambari, Chandrapeda meets that Kadambari and he falls in love with her. So that's how the story goes later. We are right in the middle before he takes up his Yuvaraja position, where Shukanasa calls him and gives him the advice. He starts off with the effects of youth, and then he talks about the effects of Guru Upadesham, the positive the effects on good people versus bad people, those who can listen to it and how it affects the people who don't want to listen to it. Sometimes you say, you know, in the kadala potent and the kadala eduthurro, it enters through one ear and goes out through the other ear. Here he would say it won't even enter into the ear of certain people. So he will start off with that. And then Chandrapeda is only going to assume at the Yuvaraja position, but still he would talk about the nature of kings, how they are so garvam, the arrogant in their position and the wealth that they possess, that the nature of kings itself is very difficult. So these three sections are very small sections, not much, whereas the Lakshmi Swabhava, his favorite person, you know, punching bag is Lakshmi here. I mean, he says Lakshmi as in wealth, not but he takes her as a female, and he starts talking about the swabhavam, how fickle minded she is, how we should be very wary of the wealth that is there. It is only a representation of the arrogance that we can we get out of that wealth that we have. Right, that is what it represents. It doesn't mean that he is directly abusing Lakshmi, Vishnu's wife. So for the entire section, we have to keep that in mind. Because someone, when I was teaching this for the first time, he said, you know, we pray to Lakshmi, Goddess Lakshmi. Why is he abusing her so much? You know, he's calling her a Veshyastri and all that. Why does he do this? He got very upset when he was reading the Shukanasa Upadesha. So that's why I'm giving this disclaimer. Please don't think of this as Goddess Lakshmi as such. But yeah. The next two sections are about how this Lakshmi would give a, you know, how it changes the behavior of people, of kings especially, because they are in position of that Rajya Lakshmi. One is they are confused. The other is they also behave in a bad manner. Being confused and doing nothing is fine. But being confused and also if you behave in a very bad manner, then that is a further problem because you are in a position where you are supposed to take a look after so many people in your country. Right? So this is in short what the sections are. And Rajnyam Vaiklavyam and Rajnyam Durvyavaharaha also is a very interesting section at the end. And then you'll have how he concludes. So it doesn't mean that Chandrapeda is the worst person and he needs all this advice. He will start to say, you know, Upadeshta, there is nothing that I need to give you as advice yet. As he starts, it's like an advice to every one of us here. If we had had this advice when we were young, I'm sure things would have changed. Such a beautiful piece. We can start the text today. Maybe look at a couple of sentences. Let me see.
So before you go ahead, one question. Actually, yes. A couple of them. The word bana itself means banati to speak, right? Bana based on words.
Is it?
One who speak?
Bhanati is bha.
Bha.
Oh, that's bha. Bhaprana. Okay. Yeah. So bana could be an arrow. That's the obvious thing. But I guess there is no.
These are all, you know, names of children. I don't know if I've told you. There is one rishi called Bhujju. Nidaga. Nidaga means summer. Why do we name? There is no particular
no logic.
Meaning for all that. You just go
what about, what the parents wish. Okay, but what about Kadambari? Kadambari has a significance? Like
Kadambari is a flower. It's flower. Also Madhyapanam. Intoxicant.
Oh, intoxicant. Okay. that's awesome. Okay.
That is why they say Kadambari Rasajnanam Aharopi Norochate. Once you know the taste of wine, you don't want food. Shukanasa Upadesh Varnanam. So it starts off with Evam. We can, one of you can read the sentence by sentence and we can go. That's fine.
Shall I try?
Yes, please.
Starting from Evam, right?
Yes, Evam.
Evam Samatikramatsu Divaseshu Raja Chandra Pidasya Yavarajyabhishekam Chikirshuhu Pratiharan Upakarana Sambara Sangrahartham Adidesha.
So, Evam Samatikramatsu Divaseshu. This is Sati Saptami. So, as Evam Purvokta Prakarena is what he would write. So, Purvokta Prakarena would be there is a small description of a woman, Patralekha, who is assigned by his mother. She is the daughter of Kuluta Desha, I think. I forget. So she's, you know, there are many vassal kings who they win over and get those. The kings are dead. The daughters are absorbed into the family or the sons are absorbed into the army. So she is one of those persons. And his mother Vilasavati, Sri Chandrapeda's mother Vilasavati, appoints this woman Patralekha as his accompaniment. So she goes with him everywhere, wherever Chandrapeda goes, and like a constant companion for him. So evam samatikramatsu divaseshu, you will find that it is how he spends patralekha tu tatav pravriti darshanenaiva samupajata sevarat na diva na ratrau na suptasya na asinasya na uttitasya. She did not leave his side even for a moment. This is how his days went by. So evam samatikramatsu divaseshu, as his days went by in the company of both Vaishampayana and Patralekha. It's how we understand this. Words here. Raja here would mean Tarapidaha, the king. Chandrapida is going to be named the prince here. He is still not the Yuvaraja. So it's not automatic here. The moment a child is born, he is the Yuvaraja. No, that's not how it happens. So the king will decide whether he can be a Yuvaraja or not, whether he has the capabilities or not. So Raja Tarapidaha, Chandrapidasya yavva rajya abhishekam chikirshuhu. Chikirshuhu, it's again Prathama Bhakti. So, kartum iccha, yasya saha. So, he has that desire to perform the Yuvaraja Abhishekam for Chandrapeda. Chandrapedasya yavvarajya abhishekam chikirshuhu. Pratiharan, Adidesha, he ordered his Pratihara. Pratihara is Dwarapalaka. Those who are at the Dwaram, doorkeepers. Yes. So they are servants, doorkeepers, Pratiharan, Adidesha, he ordered them for what? Upakarana sambhara sangrahartham. Upakarana upakarana is abhisheka samagri, the materials that are necessary for the abhishekam. So upakarana sambharam sambharaha samuhaha tesham sangrahartham. Samuhasya sangrahartham, sangrahartham, in order to collect, or to, even if we have one small puja in our house, we will first line up everything, whatever we need for the puja, like Ganesha puja today, right? So we'll just line up everything first. So that is what he wanted. If it's a great kingdom and where he wants to do the Yavvarajya Abhishekam, these are all, why I'm pointing out these things is, see, the observation that Bana has to details is just amazing. This is nothing that you are seeing. If you look at the different descriptions that he says, it's even more, he goes into detail about certain things. Like even getting up onto a horse, simple descriptions like that, he would say about how he would caress the horse, hold on to the, and the kadivalam, that reins, and then put his left leg on one, and then the other. Such detailed descriptions would be there in his literature, before or after, wherever. So, upakarana sambhara sangrahartham adidesha, the king ordered the pratihara, the doorkeepers, to collect all the materials that were necessary for the Yuvaraja Abhishekam. Okay, next. Samupasthita. You can read. You can continue today and maybe next class someone else can.
Okay, sure. Yeah. Samupasthita yauvarajya abhishekancha. Tam kadachit darshanartam agatam arudha vinayam api vinita taram ichchan shukanasah savistaram uvacha. Savistaram uvacha.
Samupasthita yavvarajya abhishekamcha tam. Tam again is a sarvanama shabda which we have to take from there, which is Chandrapeda. Chandrapidam samupasthita yavvarajya abhishekam tam chandrapidam kadachit darshanartham agatam. So this goes to everything being in dvitiya vibhakti is an adjective to tam, and that tam is indicates Chandrapida here. So Shukanasaha savistaram uvacha. Shukanasa said in detail to Chandrapida, who is samupasthita, whose yavvarajya abhishekam was nearing. Samupasthitam samipe sthitam. It was very close by. He was going to get crowned as the yuvaraja. Tasya abhishekam samupasthitam. Tam chandrapedam kadachit once darshanartham agatam. He had just chanced upon, that's all. And Shukanasa just grabbed that opportunity and gave him the advice. So, kadachit darshanartham agatam. He just came to visit. Chandrapeda came to visit Shukanasa. Darshanartham agatam. Arudha vinayamapi. This is very important. So, he was already vinayaha. Vinayaha here is not humility. In any literature, if you take even Kalidasa, he does not use the word vinaya for humility. We say vidya dadati vinayam vinaya dyati patratam and all that, but vinayaha nayati leading, or vinayaha most, it means disciplined. Shastre shastra marge gamanam eva vinayaha. That is showing not humility, but it means you are extremely disciplined. So arudha vinayam api, even though he was disciplined, vinita taram ichchan, he wanted him to go more in that path of shastram. So vinita taram ichchan, he wanted to make him even more can say disciplined. I'm not sure what other word I can use for this. Vinamraha. He uses vinamratara. Okay, Ichanna Abhilashanna. He wanted, Shukanasa wanted him to be more good towards his prajaha because he's going to take up the position of Yuvaraja. So Vistaram Uvacha, he said in detail. And he starts off the first line itself. See, when you're going to advise someone, you don't say, you know, don't do this, don't do that. The way he starts off itself is beautiful. Yeah.
Tata Chandra Pida. Vidita Veditavyasya Vidita Veditavyasyaha
extra line, you don't need to
Vidita Veditavyasya Adhita Sarva Shastrasya Te Nalpa Matyupadeshtavyam Asti.
So Vidita Veditavyasya Adhita Sarva Shastrasya Te Na Alpam api upadeshtavyam asti. You know everything. That's the best way to start off with a child. So tata chandra pida. So, tata is tataha. If you look up in dictionary, it would mean father. So tataha is like father. But when we say, when we call a child, especially in Tamil, appa inge variya. Koranda, even for a child, we say appa. It's a very common usage in Tamil, I find. So it, I don't know which. Even Telugu in Telugu, I think there is.
Yeah. It's a
Naina. Nana. Ikadrapa is the same thing.
Even in Kannada also we say that.
That's a lot of South Indian languages, I find we use that word, right? So Tata Chandra Pida, Konda. Appa, come here. No, that's how he says. See that affection that you find even in that address. Vidita Veditavyasya. The Shashti Vibhakti goes to Chandrapidasya here. Vidita, whatever that has to be understood, has been understood. So Veditavyam is that which has to be understood. Tat sarvam viditam toya. You have understood whatever has to be learnt. Adhita Sarva Shastrasya. Because you have learnt all Shastras, you know what has to be known. Just why these two seem very, one seems redundant, right? No. Adhita Sarva Shastrasya, you have bookish knowledge. Vidita Veditavyasya, you have also applied it, you understand it in your life. It is not redundant here. Even though Gadyam is a big playground for Bana to use a lot of words, he won't. There is a purpose for it. So Adhita Sarva Shastrasya, you have the knowledge. And Vidita Veditavyasya, what has to be learnt from those books, the concept that needs to be learnt also has been learnt. Right? Then, Tadrishasya Tava Te Na Alpamapi Upadeshtavyam Asti. I don't have to advise you at all. Then why are you starting? The whole thing is, he would say, you will know why he says that. That's his method. Next book. One more sentence and then we can stop.
Kevalancha nisargata eva bhanu bhedyam aratna.
So eva abhanu bhedyam.
Abhanu bhedyam aratna lokat chedyam apradipa prabhapaneyam atigahanam tamaha yauvana prabhavam.
So Yavvana Prabhavam, he starts his speech of effects of Yavvanam here. He says, I don't need to advise anything to you, but yet, you know, Yavvanam is such a stage in life that it is so, it's filled with darkness. Tamaha, Yavvana Prabhavam, Yavvanat Utpadyate Tamaha. So Yavvana Prabhavam Tamaha, the darkness that comes out of Yavvanam is extremely ati gahanam. It's so deep. It's very thick tamas here. Tell me about it. Two teenagers and I know how it is. Kevalam cha nisargataha eva. By naturally nisargataha eva. Abhanu bhedyam. It is not a tamas that can be easily pierced by Surya. bhanubhedyam na asti iti abhanubhedyam tamaha. Any andhakaram that you have seen can be destroyed by three sources of light. One is Agni, the other is Surya, the other is Ratnam. He does not include Chandra here, because even though the Chandra is present, there is andhakaram in some corner or the other. Even it's not completely gone, right? And Chandra, the moon, also derives its source from the sun. So the sources of light are three. One is Surya, so Abhanu Bhedyam. The second one is Ratnam, Ratna Pradipaha. Kumarasambhatla, Ratnam. I forget that. So there, if you go into the caves, there is always that Ratna Pradipam present there. It is filled with gems, and there is no Andhakaram inside the caves in Himalayas. Kalidasa would describe in that manner. So, Aratna Aloka Chedyam. Ratna Alokaha Ratna Prakashaha. Ratna Prakashena Chedyam. It can be destroyed by Ratna Prakashaha. It cannot be destroyed. So, Ratna Alokena Na Chedyam Iti Aratna Aloka Chedyam. That's how the samasa is constructed here. So, Abhanu Bhedyam. Bhanu Bhedyam Yat Nasti Tat Abhanu Bhedyam Tamaha. Right? So, Abhanu Bhedyam, it cannot be destroyed by Surya. Aratna Aloka Chedyam, it is an Andhakara that cannot be pierced by the light that emanates from gems.
Aloka, Aloka itite.
Alokaha Prakashaha. Prabha, Prakashaha. He uses three words here. Right? Prabha, Prakashaha, no, not Prakasha, Abhanu. Bhanu itself is enough here. You know that it is Prakasha Yuktam. Pradipa Prabha Apaneyam Na Vidyate. So, yesya yate apradipa Prabha Apaneyam. The third word he uses is Pradipam here. The flame. Any flame can also destroy the darkness here. That Agni can also, this Yavvana Prabhavam Tamaha, the darkness that comes out of Yavvanam cannot be destroyed even by a flame. Even by Agni. So, Tadrasham Tamaha Yavvanam. This is just the beginning of it. This is not the... that itself is like a punchline here. No? It starts off with a bang. Kevalancha Nisargataha Eva. It is just that, you know, I don't need to give you any advice. But just that the darkness that comes out of Yavvanam is so strong. Ati Gahanam Nisargataha Eva. It's not because of you. It is Yavvanam. It is the fault of Yavvanam. That's why he says...
You mean natural? It is natural in that?
Swabhavikataya.
Swabhavika. Ast, okay.
Nisargatayeva. Swabhavikataya yavvanat yat tamaha upajayate tatitu ati gahanam vidyate. Stop with this. Is it okay?
Yep. Excellent.